In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motion of the upper cervical spine in sitting position.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physio Tutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of manual practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypomobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A systematic review done by Van Trifel et al. In the year 2005 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the cervical spine and found an overall reliability of poor to fair. However, for segments C1, C2 and C2, C3, at least fair reliability was reached consistently. For this reason, we give this examination a moderate clinical value. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment for upper cervical spine flexion of vertebrae C0 till C3, have your patient sit upright at the edge of the bench or on a stool. The bench height should be adjusted so that your patient's head is on the same height as your belly. First, fixate the spinous process of C3 with a key grip into ventrocranial direction. Be aware that this is the other way around than in other parts of the spine due to the ligamentous connections of the upper cervical spine. Then your working hand is placed low on the patient's occiput and the patient's head is fixated between your working hand and chest. Now perform a maximal heteronymous 3D movement with equal components of flexion, contralateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation. For the regional assessment of upper cervical spine extension, change your fixation of C3 into ventrocaudal direction and place your working hand higher on the patient's occiput. Then perform a maximal heteronymous 3D movement with equal components of extension, contralateral, lateral flexion and ipsilateral rotation. Both movements are judged on resistance during motion and at end range, range of motion, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. For upper cervical spine assessment, be aware that a limitation at C2, C3 can influence movement of the higher segments. For this reason, C2, C3 has to be assessed first. Click on the info button in the top right corner in order to watch a video on how to assess this segment. A limitation of C0, C1 can limit movement of C1, C2. For this reason, we will start with the segmental assessment of C0, C1 first. First, fixate your patient's spinous process C2 with a key grip. Then place your hypothena eminence on the patient's mastoid process on the contralateral side and fixate the patient's head with your chest. Then rotate your patient's head until you feel resistance. To assess movement at C0 or C1, perform a lateral flexion movement to the contralateral side by a coupled movement between your working hand and your chest. The movement has to take place around the sagittal axis through the nose of your patient. Furthermore, you can specify if the limitation lies on the contralateral or the ipsilateral condyle of the occiput. To pronounce the downslip movement of the contralateral condyle of C0, perform the same lateral flexion movement with C0, C1 in extension. To pronounce the upslip movement of the ipsilateral condyle of C0, perform the same lateral movement with C0, C1 in flexion. For the assessment of C1, C2, keep your fixation and move your hypothena eminence of your working hand down to the contralateral arch of C1. Your patient's head is in neutral position and no lateral flexion is present. Then rotate maximally and assess the end feel. Both movements are judged on resistance during motion and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. Alright, this was our video on intervertebral motion assessment of the upper cervical spine in sitting position. If you want to learn how to assess intervertebral motion of the upper cervical spine in supine position, click on the video right next to me. As always, Thanks a lot for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if it was helpful to you. Click on the subscribe button and the little bell icon next to it in order not to miss any future videos. This was Kai for Physio Tutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.